Good morning. Okay, so I've had a week off. Had a nice little vacation. But I'm back at it. So we need to continue building our little debus server and client for the rewrite of Snippet Pixie. And I was at a bit of a weird place. With building the client. Let me just quickly fix up plugin because that's important. Right. So my issue was I've got a I'm creating a connection and debus object and it's returning a bus object interface as part of that which is impossible to then pass on to a function as a receiver. So in here, I'm having to pass it in as a value object effectively, which is not what I want to do. What I want to do is I want to have effectively an interface and call all my functions on it. So I think because I'm new to Go and its type system and in particular how inheritance and interfaces work, I had to do a little bit of research and I'm still not 100% on what I'm going to do, but I want to have a little play to see if I can get closer to what I want. So I read this little post here in Golang by example on inheritance in Go using interface and structures. So you can basically embed, you can embed both in a structure and also in an interface, kind of. So here what they're doing is they are creating an instance of the base struct here and then assigning that to the child structure. And therefore they can call on the child the same the methods that are exposed on the child on the base here. As if, you know, it is a it's also basically got the iBase interface. And it just so happens that in Dbus, in the Go Dbus library, what we're getting back is a bus object interface which has all these methods. And then of course you've got a object type which happens to implement all those methods. So I think, or at least I'm going to try to see if I can basically embed the type object, which is a struct, inside my own struct, and then extend that with like ping and whatever else functions I want. So I'm going to have a go at that. I'm not sure how far we'll get, but we'll have a go. So, what I need to do is create something a little bit more usable, in this CLI. So let's double check that this is all working. I don't think I've made any changes. So I'll run the server. So it's running there. And now if I run this client, which isn't structured as I want it to be, hopefully, what we're calling, we're going to get Wibble back because I'm calling ping and I'm saying I want you to return Wibble. So I'll just do ping. Yep. So ping went Wibble. Okay. Stop them. So where should I define these things? Let's do it in here for the moment. So I want, I already have, can I do that? No, I guess we'll see. I'm just wondering whether I can actually mess about with another packages. Yes, I'm sure I can. I must be able to. Okay, so I'm going to have a type. I'm going to call this service caller. And I'm going to embed dbus.object, and because object implements the interface, the thingy interface here, we should be good. He says, so let's expand these things. Right. So what we're doing is we're getting back the dbus object. Now that's not what I want. What I want to rename this. I want back a service caller. So let's rename this. Where is it trying to do that? Command center, run. Yes, I want to change that. And yes, I want to do that as well. So in main, double check. Come on, expand. Thank you. Right. So we're getting a new service caller there. Okay. So, and I want to return a service caller. And it's going to be a pointer, I think, this time. So, service caller. Let's rename this. To Sarah's call, I guess. Do that. Just to set expectations. And then, because this is a... Ah, no, actually. Let's leave that. Ah, no. Yeah. Let's get back the object. And then as per this, we'll just instantiate this with the object. So this is different. The problem is my function is returning one of these, but I have to embed another struct. So does that work? I guess we'll find out. Okay, so service caller is going to be address of service caller, and I'm going to assign I guess it has to be that, does it? Yeah, it's going to be a problem. Okay. So how do I do that then? Do I give it a name? But then it's... That doesn't make sense. How do I get that back as... and then embedded. So I don't think, I mean, obviously I can't do that because you won't know what it is. No. I guess I could do that. Do I need, is that what I need to do? Inherit it through another type? That's getting a bit silly. Or, I mean, what happens if I do? Not gonna like it, is it? I know, this is the thing. I don't get it. I don't get how I'm supposed to be able to pass these things around. It's fighting me every what. So. And that just doesn't feel right anyway. Ah, I recognize that. I'm very confused right now. How can I get? How can I get that base? If it's returning a my base, which is effectively what's happening here. Do I just cast it? Can I do that? Can I do dbus? Object. Apparently not. Can I convert an expression of the type bus object to the type object? Even though it implements the interface. I know I'm saying all the wrong things here because I'm used to different types of object oriented languages, but and I know this isn't strict object orientation. But But why can't I do anything with this thing, this interface that's coming back? Right, let's have a look at the code. See, it's even returning an object. Stuff. That's examples. Okay, so look at the example code. Well, test stuff. Take back an object. Let's just call it straight away. Calls it. Just hang out. It's not, I'm not seeing. How I can use this easily outside of its own context as such. All these tests are using the object straight away with a call. I'm not seeing any. Any casting of it as such. I guess I need to do some more reading up because this isn't working. Got the interface. It's implemented by object. Like that. And then I come along. Is something that returns. Hold on a minute. That's what if No, it's not going to work. Do that. Oops. So if I just say, okay, right, I know it's an interface. Does that instantiate? Maybe. Okay, and then in here, I think this is going to be a mess, but we'll give it a go. So here we have service caller. Let's call it service caller. Just call it a service, actually. Okay. So I assign the bus object to an embedded bus object. Return that service caller. Pass that in, response, do the thing. And then here, service. Let's double check that then. So create my own structure called service caller, which embeds a bus object, which means it inherits its methods, and then return one of those. With the address or a pointer to. a debus object that satisfies the interface. Turn one of them, and then in main, I grab that cool ping on it. Hey, up. Does that work? Let's find out. Run them server. Run the client. It worked. Okay. I think we've got it. Right. So. That's cool. Here's right, so here's the issue here, right? So that's not correct. That should be. Service, and then I should have a type service cooler, which is the interface, and that has a ping. It takes a string. Do I have to do the whole thing, don't I? Response string that returns a string and or error. And then I believe I can then get shot of that. Make sure that's correct. Takes a service. So. I'm defining a service caller interface. Why is that complaining? Get to that in a sec. I think I might need to do the same as they did. So I'm getting back. Connection service and error. Yeah, I'm going to keep that service cooler there because I might need to switch that out in a sec. I think I get it now. Right, it's from the daemon again. I should just keep that going, really. Run the thing. Red ribble, that's good. And then if I instead say I'm returning a service caller, because I am. Just like the bus object returns a bus object interface. And then in here, it's just the same. I'm getting back a service caller. And service caller has ping. Which is satisfied by this function on the service. Okay. That's cool. Right. Let's give that a go then. Where was it? Control F10. Rent ribble. Okay. And if I change this to just empty. I should, in theory, get Pong back. I do. Ping went Pong. Right, okay. I think we've cracked it. Right, that took a little bit of working out. I think I've learned a lot there about how Go interfaces and structures interfaces work, basically. That's really helpful. So now I can set up a bunch of functions that hang off the service, and I just call them, and inside I just know I need to call the service. And before we go any further, well, let's do that. Let's just commit that because that's working. And we'll clean up other stuff later. So what's changed? Quite a bit. We've added we've refactored it to give us a service caller. Okay. To CLI. Add service caller. To hack functions. That'll do. And I should probably push that actually. Oh, I don't need to. It's been a while. Yep. Okay. safety. Okay, I'm going to quickly change a couple of things here as well. So main, we're kind of okay. We're just doing a quick ping just for a test at the moment. That's okay. That's going to change when we do flags and things in a minute. But here, I'm starting to repeat things. So let's take this out. And we'll have this as is that a destination? Yeah, so we'll call it base dest. That's a constant. I'm going to have another one. This path. I'll just go grab that. I wonder if they should be exposed. Let's do that. Because I'm going to be reusing them quite a bit outside. So here, we'll have base dest. Oops. So in theory that still works. Did that come out? Test that. That worked. So what that does, I don't need to keep using that string all over the place. I just use base test, base pass. So if I ever change this interface, I can, it's just in two places there, which I'll have to do in the main and daemon here as well. Oh, daemon. Yeah, so really, we could do with extracting that into a package. Because then anyone can call it and implement it however they see fit. But do I want to do that? If I expose that, if I set that interface up, basically, what I'm trying to think of is if I set this up so this is in a common place, then the CLI and the GUI can both have their own service struct, which then implements all the functions. Which makes them consistent and adhere into the same interface, which is quite important. But in the demon. Gonna have similar, aren't we? The thing is, it returns a different type of error. So it'd be similar. It'd be a service handler. do different things. Think. Yeah, I think what we'll do is we'll create a new directory here, and we'll call it Should I do that? service. Cool. Yeah. Oh, yeah, I could just do it in here. Go mod init github.com snippet pixie. Snippet pixie package service caller. Okay. And then yep. We will take this stuff. You go file service caller. Chuck that in there. So it's just defining an interface at the moment. And then in here, take that out. I wonder if it will recognize that I can import that now. Oh, I have to do the redirect thing, don't I? Because it's a local module at the moment. But let's see what happens. So... GitHub.com Snippet Pixie. Is that the one? I do. Right, so what's it not like? Yeah, so I have to do a and then go try and remember what it is. Go mod. Go help mod it. So look at the dogs. I can't see what I'm looking for there. So I want to actually use a local module now. Okay. Go mod edit and replace. So, all right, let's save a few things here. That might need to change in a minute. I'm in CLI up there, so I've got there. So how do I hold on a minute? So, how do I? Ah. Let's try that then. Go mod edit, replace. Go mod edit, replace that at B not dot not dot not. Is that right? Let's see, I just want to see if this puts in the required as well. Unpublished equals. There's all the equals here. Package. Look at the auto thingy for me. Ugh. Unpublished equals, right, CLI. Win command package service cobbler. Interesting. Okay. So you do the, you could do the replace and then do the go mod tidy. All right, now hopefully it's found it now. Unused. Great. Okay. Not sure if this is saving me much, though. Guess it just makes everything consistent. So we now have somewhere to define the interface. And the services path, our destination path. And now in my client, I can create a service that uses that destination path. And we have a function here that uses it. In the main, we need to probably fix things up here as well. Or not. It's interesting, I didn't need to do the import there. Or did it automatically? No. Okay. Right. Let's see if this works. I'm not convinced it will. Run the server. Run the client. It did. Okay, it worked. Went wrong. Okay. And then in here, I don't want all this mucked up in here, really, do I? So let's I think I want to refactor this out. Because, what do I need to? I don't really need to. that's doing connection, all the stuff there. We've got, I mean, this is where we really need to move things out. I need to do a lot of work here to call different stuff. I guess it's a good start. And what I'm thinking is, I don't really want a file called dbus. With all that. Well, I suppose it does do the dbus calls. Let's keep it as his for now. Should really get on my day. So let's commit this off. Great service caller. Yeah, no. Just do it like, okay, so I'll do service caller package to define client interface. Now I'll do. Smart. That's enough for today. So we now have a client that at the moment basically just calls ping function on the service, which is adhering to the service caller interface, which is smart. That's good. So now in the future, I'll be able to refactor a bit more and start adding things like add and get, whatever, all the snippets, basically fleshing out all the functions that we created here. So we've got all these things that we need to sort of go through to. So we'll be proxying them in a way. But yeah, that's cool. Good stuff. That's plenty for today. All right. Thank you for watching. And until next time, you take care.